As previously mentioned, Chiefs receiver Tyreek Hill investigated in a case involving battery of a child. The police reports don't contain a lot of information other than there were two separate incidents at the address where Tyreek Hill lives. His name was mentioned in one report from a couple of weeks ago. The report from last week, though, that reportedly resulted in a three-year-old child having a broken arm. That, again, is a report from the Kansas City Star. That has sparked an investigation of Tyreek Hill. We don't know where it's going to go. It's all just an investigation at this point. There's been no arrest, no charges, no specific allegations against Hill. But given his history, there was an incident in 2014. He ultimately pleaded guilty to assaulting his then-pregnant girlfriend. The girlfriend was pregnant with the child, who is the potential victim in this case. Because of that history, because of the fact that Hill entered the NFL without any specific discipline, although his fifth-round draft stock had something to do with that incident, he was never suspended by the league because it predated his arrival to the league. That past incident will come back, and it will affect him if there is a violation of the personal conduct policy, because that is one of the aggravating factors. Conduct you engaged in before joining the NFL. And I think there's been some frustration by some around the league that Tyreek Hill did get a second chance from the NFL because of the heinous nature of the allegations he ultimately admitted to. But no suspension for that. If he is found to have done something as it relates to his child now by law enforcement or by the NFL, there's going to be a real problem for Tyreek Hill, Chris.
Yeah, I mean, huge problem. There's no doubt about that. And I mean, the allegations and all the things that happened before the draft, it is with the woman that he's married to now, right? Or engaged to at the very least, right?
Engaged.
Yes. Sorry. But yes, this is not a good look. And certainly we got to get to the bottom of this and figure out what exactly happened. I mean, as I mentioned to start the show, my wife one time pulled my little girl's arm out of the socket, you know, accidentally playing around. With her swinging her back and forth, she got milkmaid's elbow. Okay, if it's something like that, playing around, hey, then accidents happen. But if it's from reprimanding the son, doing something along that way where he was rough and trying to teach him a lesson, wow, this is a bad look for Tyreek Hill. And I would think that he is in deep, deep trouble. His career would be deep, deep trouble.
The reality is this gets investigated, right? How are they going to prove it? Yeah. There are going to be individuals who are questioned. Yes. There will be a certain amount of objective evidence, but absent a video. And we saw what happened with Kareem Hunt.
Right.
Kareem Hunt was accused of misconduct in February of 2018, and nothing happened, and nothing was going to happen until the video came out. So it may very well be that, and let's be realistic about this. Tyreek Hill's on the doorstep of a major contract.
Yeah.
And if I'm the Chiefs now, I may want to wait a year before doing that. This may give me all the cover that I need to say, look, I'm not giving you $20 million a year.
Yeah, right.
We got to wait and see how this plays out and how you play out over the next year. But, you know, there's going to be an incentive by witnesses who have an attachment to Hill to be, again, this is all
I get you.
But the evidence may be imperfect, Chris. That's the thing. If we say if he's proven to have done it, how are they going to prove that he did anything? That's going to be for the authorities to look into and for the NFL to look into. Because remember, once the authorities close the book on this, they can close the book and not arrest him. But just ask Ezekiel Elliott whether that gets you out of hot water with the NFL. He still ended up being suspended 6 games by the league, even though he was never arrested. So this is something that is going to be an issue for Hill and the Chiefs and the Kansas City Star's editorial board on Saturday. No uncertain terms.
Right.
If he did this, the Chiefs must cut ties with Tyreek Hill.
Yeah.
The question, though, is where did, because he's too good to not get that second chance. Your talent gets you that second chance.
Yeah.
And if he is available, I mean, maybe the NFL needs to protect the other teams from themselves and just banish the guy from the NFL, given what happened in 2014. If, and again, the key word here is if it's found that he did anything to his three-year-old child.
Yeah, if he did anything to his three-year-old child along with the 2014, the suspension needs to be significant. I mean, that, you know, hey, this is not a second chance. This will be a third chance. I mean, yes, I know the first one didn't fall under the, you know, the bylaws of the NFL because he was yet to be under contract with the team, but we all know about it. It's not a good look. And if this is added to it, then yeah, I got to question the man altogether. But hey, just from a pure football standpoint too, let's just make sure we get this out there. Tyreek Hill was the most dangerous wide receiver in football last year. There was nobody more dangerous. He is so good that Bill Belichick and the New England Patriots double-teamed him every play in the AFC Championship game, except for about three or four plays the whole game. So that tells you what kind of special player he is for not only himself but the Chiefs, and this would be a huge blow, and I certainly hope he didn't do these things that he's the allegations that are not true.
Yeah, and true. given the history, if he right. did it again, then that's something the NFL needs to take very seriously.
Hi, I'm Mike Tirico, and thanks for watching. Make sure to hit subscribe for the latest news and highlights from NBC Sports.